Hello everyone, welcome to the next video on convolution code part 4. In the previous video we saw how to design a convolution code encoder, that was done in part 1. Then in part 2 we saw how to make the state diagram for the given convolution code problem. In the third video we saw how to obtain the code word sequence for the given data sequence with the given state diagram. Now in this video we will see how to make the trellis diagram. State diagram, trellis diagram and code 3 are the three ways to represent the convolution code. So we will see how to design or how to develop a trellis diagram. So this was our given problem. We are doing this problem in which there are two stages in the shift register. There are three modulo 2 adders which give you three different outputs, V1, V2 and V3, based on the generators G1, G2 and G3. We had developed this encoder with the help of generators, and the output equations V1, V2 and V3 gave us the required code word sequence as shown here. This was done in the first video. Now from this diagram and then from this table we will obtain the trellis diagram, the output using trellis diagram. In trellis diagram also we will follow these states. State A would be 00, state B would be 01, state C as 10 and state D as 11. This is the present state, next state table and the corresponding output table that we saw while designing the state diagram. So I'll just quickly explain you how to obtain this. So when the input is 0 and we are in state A, that is 00, next state would be state A and the corresponding output will be 000. This was explained while we were making the state diagram. Now, these are the four states A, B, C and D. Okay. And we will have similar next states A, B, C, D. And we will start with state A because initially our flip-flops are reset or shift register contents are 00. So we start with state A. Input 0 will be represented by orange dashed arrow and input 1 will be represented by green arrow with solid line. So when we are in state A and when input 0 arrives, the next state is state A itself and the corresponding output is 000. When we are in state A and input 1 arrives, the next state is state C and the corresponding output is 111. To understand how we have obtained this table, you will have to refer to the third part, convolution part 3 video, and understand how this table is obtained. And we can see part 2 as well. Now, these are my next states. Next states are A and C. Now for state A, the next state will remain same for input 0 and for input 1. So when we are in state A and input 0 arrives, we will be in state, we will remain in state A and the corresponding output will be 000. And when we are in state A and input 1 arrives, we will go to next state which is equal to C. So this is the output corresponding to input 1 when we are in state A. Now in this stage, when we are in state C and input 0 arrives, our next state would be, state C is represented by 10. So when we are in state C and input 0 arrives, the next state is state B and the corresponding output is 011. when we are in state C and input 1 arrives. The next state is state D and the corresponding output is 100. The same thing will follow for the remaining state C's. So for input 0, the next state would be state B and output will be 011. And for input 1, the next state would be state D and corresponding output will be 100. Now here we have to deal with two more states which are B and D. So when we are in state B and input 0 arrives, when we are in state B is represented by 01. So when we are in state B and input 0 arrives, the next state is state A and the corresponding output is 101. So we go to next state which is A and the corresponding output is 101. When we are in state B and input 1 arrives, the next state is when we are in state B and input 1 arrives, the next state is state C which is 10 and the corresponding output is 010. Similarly, we draw the same thing for remaining two states B. Okay. Now, when we are in state D and input 0 arrives, the next state would be state B and the corresponding output will be 110. And when we are in state D and input 1 arrives, we remain in state D and the corresponding output will be 001. So we do the same thing for this state D as well. So this is how we can prepare trellis diagram for all the states A, B, C, D. The next states after this state will be replica of these states, these outputs. Okay. Now we will actually see how to find the code word for the given data sequence using the trellis diagram. So this is the trellis diagram which we had obtained. In this trellis diagram, we have 7 stages corresponding to 7 data input bits. Okay. Now let us start from state A, because as mentioned earlier, initially when we start or switch on our circuit, the shift register contents are reset and the contents of shift register are 00, and 00 here in our example is represented by state A. So initially we are in state A. When data input 1 arrives, our next state should be state C and the corresponding output should be 111. Please recollect that the dashed arrow here represents input 0 and the solid arrow here represents input 1. So we are in state A and the first data bit is 1. The corresponding output will be 111. And the next state would be state C. We have represented this transition by this purple solid line. Now we are in state C. Input 0 arrives. Our next state is B. And the corresponding output is 011. We are in state B. And the third bit 0 arrives. We go to state A. And the corresponding output is 101. Now in state A, fourth bit 1 arrives. Our next state would be state C with corresponding output 111. When in state C, the fifth bit 1 arrives, our next state would be state D and the corresponding output will be 101. Now we are in state D and the next bit 0 arrives. We go to next state B and the corresponding output would be 110. Now we are in state B and the last 7th bit 0 arrives. We are expected to go to state A and the corresponding output will be 101. So this is how we have seen how to obtain the code word sequence using the given trellis diagram. I end my video here, and in the next video I will explain you how to develop a code tree for the given convolution code encoder and how to find the corresponding code word sequence when the data input sequence is given. Thank you very much for listening.